The Kitchen Knife. The 80s and B-movie slasher flicks may have portrayed the knife as an evil and dangerous product, but we are here to reclaim the knife as our friend. Most people have a good cutting knife at home. One thing I will say, it is worth getting sharpened if you can. Nothing quite beats the feeling of a nice sharp knife cutting through some veggies. The cutting board. Plastic or wooden? If the knife was single and was looking for a compatible partner, then he, she, or they would have to look no further than the cutting board. They go together like butter and popcorn. You probably have a plastic cutting board hiding out in your kitchen somewhere, just waiting to be used. For skinnier and lighter cutting boards, use a wet rag underneath it to stabilize it and keep it from sliding around. Wooden cutting boards are my favorite, but they do require a little more maintenance, which you can see I didn't really do a good job of. Again, use what you have in your kitchen already. Even though certain foods may give you gas, gear, acquisition, syndrome, your dreams of finer utensils don't have to.
How much is enough?
But seriously, I hear some people talk about kitchen utensils like others do about video and music gear. Just start with what you have and trust that you'll be able to grow your kitchen utensil arsenal over time. The spoon. If you're like me, the thought of a kitchen spoon does not bring back fond memories from childhood. Spoons help us to stir around those veggies, help us break up the meat, blend them all together, and generally prevent our foods from sticking to the pan and creating a massive headache to clean, or worse yet, burning those delicious meals we've been dreaming of making for days. If you need a spoon, just open up your silverware drawer. Again, let's start with what we have and build from there. A metal spoon can be just fine, especially if you're trying to keep it simple and figuring out if cooking is something you want to do more of before investing money you may or may not have on a bunch of other utensils. The pan. That's right, a good solid saute pan is something you will come to love. But if you don't have a saute pan, then you can get creative and use a pot with a really wide bottom. Really, any size pot will do. The pot. A good pot can get you a lot of mileage, like a Tesla on one charge. You can use it to boil and blanch those veggies, and you can also use it to saute foods as well. So that's one way to solve the problem of missing out on a saute pan. Some other utensils you can get if you have some extra cashola would be a spatula, a whisk, and I don't know. How about a trusty strainer? This is kind of an essential though too. And finally, the last kitchen essential you need is music. You need something to move to, something to groove to, help you keep your rhythm and your flow. Now, what kind of music that is up to you. Like someone's favorite food, it's a matter of personal taste.